Okay, the topic of today or the class of today is about reading, okay? And this reading, the title of this reading is about life in the past, okay? Life in the past. For example, this picture, okay, is about a culture. This picture. What culture is this? Is a Peruvian culture? No. This culture is from, okay, what country? Students? Hello. What culture is this? ¿Qué cultura? Yes.
Egipto?
Yes, from Egypt, yes. So today we're going to know more from culture, in this case, from Egypt culture. And then we are going to have a practice, okay? So let's start with the vocabulary of today. Okay, these are tools. Tools means herramientas, okay? For example, these are, okay, the tools in the, or these were tools in the past, okay? Continue. This, in the number two, okay, this is an statue. For example, this is an statue of a cat. Can you see? This is a statue, okay? This is a statue of a cat. This is an animal. In Egypt, it was very common to see statues of animals. Okay, for example, cats. In the number three, here you can see jaguarly. What is jaguarly in Spanish? Joyería. Yeah. Yes. In Egypt, it is very common to see this kind of jaguarly. Okay? Okay. And finally, in number four, you can see a board game. Miss, what is a board game? Board game es un juego de mesa. Claro, ellos también se divertían, ¿no? En la antigüedad, in the past, they play using a board game, okay? For example, this is a board game, like a chess, ¿no? Parece un juego de ajedrez, like a chess, okay? So everybody, please pay attention to the vocabulary of today. The number one, tools. The number two, it's an statue. The number three, jewelry. The number four, it's a board game. Any question? Yes? Any question?
Pregunta.
Yes, Reyes?
Este, ¿eso está en el libro?
No, no yet, no todavía. Luego lo van a ver. Ok, pero no, en el workbook no está. Está en el student book, ok, en el libro del student book. Pero como no lo tienen, les estoy mostrando como imagen. Ok, Julia. De todas maneras, ok, de todas maneras ustedes saben que yo les puedo enviar una captura de pantalla y ustedes de manera libre lo pueden imprimir y luego pegar en el cuadernito de inglés. Ok.
Sí, yo tengo el student book.
Ah, perfecto. Si tú tienes el student book, ahí está, ¿no? Es la unidad number five. Estamos en unit number five. Ok, very good. Recuerden que este año solamente estamos trabajando con workbook, ¿ok? Pero si hay algo del student book que les quiera mostrar, les muestro por diapositiva para que todos también puedan verlo. Let's continue, students. Ok. Continue with... One moment, please. Let's continue with this video. Okay, in this video, you are going to know more about the culture in Egypt, okay? In the past, obvious. For example, this question says, what do primary sources tell us about life in the past? Okay? Y en este caso se está refiriendo a, ¿qué crees que significa primary sources? Vamos, chicos, investiguen, usen su diccionario, puede ser a, ¿ah?
¿Qué cultura es?
No, primary sources. ¿Qué significa primary sources? Vamos, chicos. Primary sources. Ok, cuento hasta tres.
Fuentes primarias.
Ok, fuentes primarias. Son objetos primarios, ¿no? Dice, what do primary sources tell us about life in the past? Ok, nos dice sobre una vida en el pasado. Por ejemplo, gracias a todas estas cositas que han encontrado, tools, statue, jewelry, board game, gracias a todo ello y a más cositas todavía, nosotros podemos saber que había vida en el pasado, ¿verdad? Que había una cultura, exacto, y cómo vivían también, ¿no? For example, people, okay, in the past used these tools, usaban estas herramientas. They made these statues. Ellos hacían esas estatuas. They were jewelry. Ellos usaban esta joyería. And they played, okay, using board games. Y ellos jugaban usando esos juegos de mesa. Entonces son evidencias. Eso se le llama primary sources, okay? Now, students, let's know about more primary sources, okay? Pay attention to this video. Wow, one moment, please. Presten atención. Ah, y les pido por favor que en este caso sí presten atención bastante al video. ¿Por qué? Porque luego vamos a tener una actividad y para eso ustedes van a tener que utilizar la información del video. ¿Ya? Así que presten atención. Si tienen alguna duda, me lo preguntan después. Ya. Confírmenme, ¿pueden ver el ok, yes. Ustedes yes, me dicen yes. Qué cosas están viendo, ¿ya? For example, look at here. One moment. Ok, what are these?
Tools.
Tools.
Tools. Very good. ¿Qué significa tools?
Herramientas.
Herramientas. Excelente. Tools. What is this?
Jewelry.
Jewelry. Excellent. ¿Qué significa jewelry? ¿Qué significa jewelry?
Joyería.
Joyería. Las joyas, pues, ¿no? Que utilizaban aquellos. No solamente utilizaba la mujer, sino también el varón. Ok, look at here. What is this?
Statue.
And what animal is this?
Statue.
Statue of a horse.
Board game.
Horse. What is this?
Board game.
All of these things, todas estas cosas, okay, they use in the past. Lo usaban en el pasado. Okay, now let's watch this video.
Miselaya.
Yes.
Miselaya, soy Dani Estruzada. Mi Mi computadora se quedó trabada y estoy entrando por mi celular. ¿Me podría dejar ingresar de nuevo?
No hay sala de espera, Denis. Puedes ingresar cuantas veces quieras.
Ay, gracias, Miss. Guess what? Guess what?
Guess what? Hi again. Welcome back to Guess What? Today we're asking, what do primary sources tell us about life in the past? First, let's find out about some old things in museums. These old dolls are in a museum. They tell us about hats and clothes that people wore in the past. This old wooden boat is in a museum, too. It shows us how boats were made in the past. This old kitchen tells us about how people prepared food in the past. This plane shows us how people flew in the air in the past. And this old gramophone shows us how people listen to music in the past. Now listen to what primary sources tell us about life in the past. A primary source is something old that tells us about life in the past. It can be an old tool, a statue, some jewelry, or a board game that people had in the past. History books that we read in school are not primary sources. This is because the writers of school books didn't live at the time they are writing about. We can learn about the past by asking questions about primary sources. We can ask, what did people use this tool for? Who made this statue, and why did they make it? What is this jewelry made of? How did people play this board game? When we can answer these questions, we learn about life in the past. Let's learn about what fossils tell us about life in the past. A fossil is something from an animal or plant. It lived long ago in the past, and we can see it now in some rocks. Look, this scientist is looking for fossils in a piece of rock. These are fossils of slugs or snails that lived long ago when there were dinosaurs. This fossil of a dinosaur bone tells us that dinosaurs were very big. And this fossil of a bird tells us about its bones and size. What do you know? What do primary sources tell us about life in the past? They tell us that people played.
Okay, student, the number one. What is the number one? Look at the picture.
Board game.
Board game. Board game. Very good, Anthony. Yes.
Board game.
Board game. Yes. Continue with the second picture.
Board games. They tell us that people used metal.
Okay, The second picture, what is the second picture?
Tools. They tell us that artists made
statue. Very good. Artists in the past, they made statues, okay? From statues of people or animals.
Statues. Good job. See you next time on Guess What? Bye.
Okay. Okay, this is the video about life in the past. Okay? Okay, did you understand the video? Did you have a question? Yes or no? All is okay? Yes? Well, okay, let's continue. So, open your English book, your workbook, in the page number 54. Open your English book, workbook, in the page number 54. Okay, in this question, you can see, what do primary sources tell us about life in the past? Okay? Okay. For example, in the instruction number one says, look and write the words under the picture. Then check the primary sources. Okay. ¿Qué objetos eran vitales? Eran primarios para ellos. Okay. ¿Qué objetos eran vitales para ellos? En aquellos tiempos, claro, en el pasado, ¿no? In the past. Okay. From ancient Egypt, ¿no? Prácticamente del Egipto antiguo. In letter A. Letter A, you can see in this picture, is about a painting. Tell us about painting. Nos dice, nos habla sobre las pinturas, ¿verdad? Painting. Okay, in this case, painting was primary sources. Yes or no? What do you say?
Yes.
Why painting was a primary source? ¿Por qué, chicos? ¿Por qué creen? Painting was primary source. According to the video. De acuerdo al video. Levante la mano un voluntario y tiene tres puntos.
¿En el pasado?
Levante la mano y tiene tres puntos. Ok, Anthony Diestra.
In the past.
For example, and the paintings, ellos en Egipto, en el Egipto antiguo, claro, usaban las pinturas, ellos hacían con sus pinturas imágenes o señalizaciones para que puedan comunicarse entre ellos. Si alguien veía en la pared alguna imagen con una instrucción, por ejemplo, podría ser con imágenes que ese lugar es peligroso, entonces las demás personas veían y ya no ingresaban. O con sus imágenes podían dar instrucciones sobre alguna historia antigua, ¿no? Entonces, it was a primary source, ¿no? Ok. Very good. Fue una fuente primaria. The painting. Ok. It was a means of communication. Ese era un medio de comunicación. Y hasta ahorita lo sigue haciendo. ¿Tú has visto en algunas películas que investigan sobre la vida en Egipto solamente o descubren cómo vivían con las imágenes? ¿Yes? ¿Con las pinturas?
Por ejemplo, Miss, como Moisés y los 10 mandamientos, Miss, también tenía bastantes imágenes.
Ok. Let's continue with the letter B. Okay, the letter B, volunteer. Leila Vázquez Melgarejo. What is the letter B? It's a history book. It's a board game. It's a yearly tools.
Miss, ¿le respondo?
Yes. What is the letter B?
Es, Statue.
A statue. Very good, Leila. It's a statue. Okay, continue with the letter C. The letter C, Matías Neira. One moment, please. Okay.
Okay, teacher.
Mati, the letter C. What primary source is this? Excellent. The letter C is tools. Okay, are tools because are in plural. Tools. Okay. ¿Qué significa tools? Las herramientas, ¿verdad? Ahí podemos ver cuchillos. Ok, hace ratito vimos por ahí un martillo, okay, etc. Continue with the letter D. The letter D, Michelita y Arleque. What is the letter D?
History book.
Excellent. Ok, this is a history book, ok? History, history book, ok? Ya sabemos, history book es un libro de historia, ¿no? Como el que tenemos ahorita en nuestra biblioteca. Todos tenemos un libro de historia. Continue with the letter E. The letter E, Juan Coaquira. Juan Emiliano Coaquira. What is?
Teacher, es board game.
Yes. The letter D, board game. Okay. And continue with the letter F. The letter F, my dear Benjamín Muñoz. Yes. What is the letter F? The letter F is a page on internet about ancient Egypt. Okay. What is? Okay, Benjamín no está. Okay. Bernal. Bernal. Luis Héctor Andrei, Bernal. What is the letter F?
Where are we?
No, the letter F. F. It's a computer. Es una computadora y ahí tiene una página.
Visiting.
Very Visiting. Good. It's a website. Okay, it's a website. ¿Qué significa website? Website is a page on internet, ¿no? Online page, es una página en internet. Puede ser una página, no sé, histórica. En este caso es una página de Ancient Egypt, que es prácticamente del Antiguo Egipto, ¿no? Ok, continue with the letter G. The letter G, Gerson Carrillo. Yes, want to participate, Gerson? Gerson. Ok, what is the letter G?
Storybook.
No, Gerson. History book ya salió hace rato. It's letter D. Okay, letter D is history book. Gerson.
Jewelry.
Jewelry. Very good. Jewelry. Okay. Very good. Yes. Now, continue. No sé quién está encendiendo su micrófono, pero está entrecortado. Por favor, apaguen el micrófono, está entrecortadísimo. Let's continue. Now, we have to make a check on primary sources, okay? Let's make a check on primary sources, okay? ¿Cuáles eran prácticamente las fuentes primarias? Okay, lo vital en aquel tiempo. For example, painting was a primary source, yes or no? What do you say? Yes, it was yes. A primary source. Yes. The statue was a primary source?
Yes.
Yes, excellent. Continue with the letter C. Tools. Tools was a primary source?
Yes.
Yes, very good, excellent. A history book. A history
no,
book.
No.
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 No, porque era un simple libro. Además, en aquellos tiempos no había esos libros. No había el papel. Okay, continue with the letter E. Board game. Board game yes. Was a primary source.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. a website.
No, 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 no.
Para comenzar, no había ni computadora en aquellos tiempos. Continue with the letter G.
Yes, yes,
yes,
yes, yes,
yes, yes or no?
Yes,
yes, yes, yes, very good. Yes. Claro, era la joyería. Ellos no, todos usaban una joyería. Ok, very good students. Finish this page. Finished activity number one.
Finish.
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 Excellent. Very good. So let's continue, okay? Let's continue with the next activity. Activity number two. Okay, in this activity, you have to look at activity number one. Look at here, the number one. Okay. Read and write the letters. Write the letters. Ah, okay. Write a letter. What letter is talking about? ¿De qué letra se está refiriendo? ¿De qué imagen? For example, in the number one says, this, okay, esto nos está hablando de la imagen. This tells us that the Egyptians like to play games. The Egyptians in the past like to play games. What is the correct picture? It's very easy. It's
board game.
Board games, yes. Board Porque game. Si acá dice, chicos, this tells us that Egyptians like to play games. Le gustaba jugar juegos. Okay, we are talking about board game. Estamos hablando sobre board games, ¿no? Los juegos de mesa. Very good. What letter is board game? Letter?
E.
Letter E. Perfect. Very good. Is the letter E. Okay, one moment. Oops. Okay. The letter E. Continue with the number two. The number two, volunteer to read, please. Volunteer to read. Alguien que no haya participado. Ok, Benjamín Muñoz Sánchez.
Benjamín. Could make and play musical instruments. Letter A, teacher, porque ahí está con la imagen tocando un instrumento.
Okay. Okay, this tells us that the Egyptians could make and play musical instrument. Very good, excellent. Very good, Benjamin Muñoz. Is the letter A. Okay, for paintings, okay, a través de las imágenes, de las pinturas que ellos realizaban, nosotros ahora podemos saber cómo era su cultura. Por ejemplo, ahí en la imagen, in this painting, we can see the musical instrument. Podemos ver los instrumentos musicales, ¿no? This tell us, nos dice, nos habla, tell us, that the Egyptians could make and play musical instruments. Okay, let's continue with the number three. Volunteer for the number three. Another, Britney Rivera. Britney.
That the
Egyptians
use tools for sharing.
Okay.
Letter C.
Okay, let's see. Yes, very good, Britney Rivera. Excellent, Britney. This tells us that Egyptians use tools for farming. Julio, te escucho muy entrecortado, hijo. Desde hace rato que has estado prendiendo tu micrófono, he estado bien entrecortado. Si tienes alguna consulta, mejor escríbelo por chat, porque te escucho muy entrecortado. No te entiendo mucho. ¿Ok? Ok. Dice, this tells us that the Egyptian used tool for farming. Nos dice esta imagen que en Egipto, los egipcios, ¿ok? Usaban herramientas. Y ahí dice for farming. ¿Están entendiendo qué significa for farming? Dice for farming. Ok. Please. Let's participate. ¿Qué significa
farming? Para la agricultura.
Para la cultura.
Agricultura, agricultura.
Ya, para la agricultura. Yo. ¿Otra información, chicos? Ok, para la agricultura. Ok. Continue with the number four. The number four, Yarif. Yarif, do you want to participate? Yarif, Saez? Yes? Ok.
Sí, yes.
These telas.
Yeah. That the Egyptians wore beautiful outfits.
Ajá.
Sería, ¿cómo se llama? La...
Leather. Letter A, B, C, D, E, F, or G? What letter?
La B.
La B. Letter B. Dice, ok. Pay attention, Yarif, ok. Vamos a prestar atención otra vez. Dice, these telas that the Egyptians, dice que nos dice que los egiptos, wore significa usaban, vestían, wore beautiful objects, usaban objetos hermosos, beautiful objects, for example, earrings, bracelet, necklace. What is? Letter A, B, C, D, E, of E, F, or G?
Yeah. La G.
Ajá, letter G. Ok, it was the letter G. What is the picture in letter G? It is the jewelry. Beautiful objects. Cuando dice beautiful objects, los objetos hermosos se refiere a jewelry, a las joyas. Ok, correcto. Continue with the number five. The number five. Vamos a continuar number five, chicos. Vamos a continuar las cinco. Después en la segunda parte de Zoom, ¿ya? Ahorita vamos a tener cinco minutitos de break. Mejor dicho, va a acabar el Zoom. Y a las... Son las 8:44. Fueron 8:45. A las 8:50, ¿correcto? 8:50. 8:50. Volvemos a ingresar. ¿Está bien? ¿Sí, chicos? Díganme, sí, mi
teacher.
Perfecto, muy bien. Mientras tanto, voy tomando la asistencia y si se cierra Zoom, ya saben, ingresamos 8:50. Reina Arizaga.
Here.
Very good. César Castillo.
Present teacher.
Uh-huh. Eddie Serna. Eddie Serna. Ok, no responde. Edgar Serna. Edgar Serna. No responde. Joaquín Chircón.